So we're back, and you are tuned in to the last segment of the Lovelace Music Experience. I'm in the studio today with Monica Gray. She came all the way down from Sharon, Connecticut with her lovely daughter, who is also a track star, high jumper. This kid's got legs that I think are like 6 feet long each, though. But anyway, so Monica, before we get into Atlantic City, because we all want to hear, look, what happens in Atlantic City, I guess, stays in Atlantic City, but not this time, folks. So what are some of your goals as a singer-songwriter? What are you really looking to do with this?
Well, if I could, really, I'm more of the writer than I am the singer. For me, it's all about the writing. And if I could team up with some people and, you know, even write for other artists and
have my daughter sing some of my songs someday.
I think that'd be pretty cool.
That would be really cool. Kind of like the Judds, but
yeah, very,
a little
very
different.
Cool. So let me ask you a question. If somebody, take a guy like me, came to you and said, hey, Monica, I'm looking for some fresh ideas. I'm looking for somebody to write a song for me. Here's a little bit about me. Here's a little bit about my past. Is that something that you would be willing to offer, be willing to do?
I would be honored to do that.
How cool would that be?
That would be very cool.
What I appreciate about that, that was kind of a setup question, really, because it's showing me and it's showing the listening audience that you are a musician that has no problem with sharing.
No.
And that's really, really important. So before we do play your last song here, let's talk about Atlantic City. Can you recall the first moment when you really discovered a passion for music and something happened to you, you had a revelation down in Atlantic City? Can you go ahead and tell the listeners a little bit about that?
Oh yeah, I used to go there on summer vacations with my parents, and I think I was 8 years old, and we were walking down the boardwalk, my mother and I, and you know, it's loud, crowded, but I heard a man playing, we were walking towards him, an acoustic guitar playing No Woman, No Cry.
By Bob Marley,
yes.
Of course. Beautiful
and
song.
I stopped, she wanted to go, I stopped and stayed there as long as I could. I couldn't take my eyes off him. I thought it was the most beautiful thing. He was there, you know, with a change cup. There was nothing in it. I was close enough to see. I really felt something in that moment. I think I just fell in love with music at that time. And I took the money out of my pocket that I had. My parents gave me to, you know, play some games on the boardwalk with.
Right.
And
you
shopping,
were how old?
And I gave it to him. I think 8.
Very young age.
Yeah.
Eight years walking the face of this earth, and this man playing this acoustic guitar on the boardwalk of Atlantic City, No Woman, No Cry. Of course, we all know the song. It's a Bob Marley song. And this really touched your heart.
Oh, yeah. I felt so connected to him. We looked at each other, and I think he knew.
Yeah.
We could.
That guy at that point in time knew that he just touched somebody's heart with the music he was playing. And I'll tell you what, there's nothing more rewarding than that.
Oh, good. So. I still wonder who he was, and, you know, my mother had to kind of drag me away, like, let's go, let's go.
And at that point,
but,
you knew, ma'am.
Yeah.
Something's going on here.
Yeah.
All right.